This is a shotgun here. Playing some of Garry's mod. I think I'm just gonna play some sandbox for right now. And then, do some, fun stuff. I need to find the, there we go. Figure I'm gonna go to the school. School. And, have some fun there. But, if you guys see me eating, it's because it's lunchtime. So I'm gonna be, eating a little bit. But, no, but guys, if you have not checked out, I posted some new. Today, to Garry's mod, or Garry's mod video. And then, there are also Six Flags videos get to upload.
When I was at Six Flags.
When I was at Six Flags. So those are now up. I know a lot of you guys are wondering where I got these headphones. They're actually
Razors.
If you guys have ever watched PewDiePie or a few other guys, you've seen them before. PewDiePie has changes often between white. I think he's had pink before. He's had the greens, I think. And then Riskrim, I can't remember what he has, but there are a few other YouTubers that use these. They're great headphones. They pick up sound like crazy, though. But they're really good headphones, and if you guys ever wanted to start on YouTube or just wanted gaming headphones so you're not blaring your stuff around your family and stuff, these are perfect for it. You could get normal headphones like Beats or something. Like, I have Beats too. I have Beats, I have normal headphones, I have these. I have Turtle Beaches for my Xbox, but if you guys wanted gaming headphones that you guys could, you know, like, what I love about these is they also have this. They also have the mic. That you can use, and it's also retractable, so it's great. And that might have just like sounded really weird just based on the fact that I think I'm using the mic in here. But these are great headphones. Razer is a great company. And if you buy a specific part, you can use it for your Xbox also. So you can buy. But you can also buy a specific part that would hook up to the end of this. So like, well, like plugging your computer, your headset port, and I wish I could show you, but that'd be unplugging, and then, yeah. But basically, you can plug something into that, and it'll be able to plug into your Xbox, which I don't get why, but whatever. But right now, it's 1:23 Sunday. And it's PM. It's not the morning. Trust me. This video will hopefully be going up right after I finished recording. If my game would like to load. Yes, I'm eating fish.
That's right. My brother broke his wrist.
Guys, I don't know if I ever told you. Another reason why I haven't been able to upload is for the past 3 weeks I've had a sprained ankle. So today will be my triumphant return to the ice. In my game today. A lot of you are probably thinking it's June. Or it's almost June. Wait. What is today? I don't have my phone. It's May 31st. Why are you playing hockey? Well, to be honest, it's spring league. So, you know. So there you go.
Is this work, is it? The boy.
Alright.
Alright. Forget this. I'm gonna just...
I don't know what that's doing.
I don't like that. I did not like having that on the screen.
If you guys have not seen, back to an old video I posted about Theory Talk.
Five Nights at Freddy's 4. The four original characters. If you have not seen the uploads on Scott's website. He originally had Freddy, like a really screwed up looking Freddy. And I'll see if I can put a photo around right now in the video. And if I can't, then I'll probably tweet out a photo. But he had Freddy, who was a messed up mother trucker. Like, he just looked crazy. Then he posted a photo of Bonnie, and a lot of people thought it can't be Bonnie because it only hurt the original Freddy they first posted. Everyone thought it can't be Freddy, he only has four fingers. But I think it was 8-Bit Gaming, if I'm not mistaken, had showed that theory is completely and utterly false and that it is Freddy. Because they zoomed in on the hand, and you could see the differentiation between a fourth and a fifth finger, just because of the drill bits on the fingers, you could just tell it was a completely different one. So that was kind of debunked. But then another thing that kind of took me off guard was the amount of heads. If you looked on the body of this Freddy, quote unquote, you could call him. I mean, it just didn't look normal. Like, it looked really weird. So, I mean, we'll take a look at my planner model real quick. Because it could be BMO, that's right. That's right, it could be Chewbacca. Who do I want to be? I also got a bunch of new stuff. These things are not accurate. I got like MK9s. I got a bunch of new stuff. Ooh. Turn down the volume. But back to the theories. So, if you guys hadn't seen the amount of heads on Freddy was just kind of insane. They looked like dog heads to a point. It was just really just just I don't even know what to call it. Just did not look right. Alright, I should probably get myself food. But basically, just the amount of heads that was on it, they just looked like wolf slash like dog heads. It was creepy. And then the Bonnie, of course, was the original purple, and just you kind of knew it was Bonnie, but. But my theory basically behind the fourth game is it's probably going to go back to the beginning, because if you guys had gotten a good ending in the original game, or in Five Nights at Freddy's 3 by beating all the mini-games, which I'll put a video on beating all the mini-games and how you would do it in order. But basically, you have to beat all the mini-games in order. Or in a specific order to get the good ending. And I'll make a video on how to do that at some point. But it'll be a pretty long video because it will take me a few tries. And for some reason I can't find good editing software. So I'll probably put annotations for what time to skip to be able to get to where specific points you want to be at. But then Chica came up. I mean, they all just look creepy. They all have razor sharp teeth. But the things that I wanted to focus on with those were what it says. It says, was it me? And if we think about it, was it me? The first thing that came to mind was the bite of 87, because there was nothing else around the fact of was it me, like. You know, we kind of understand who we are as a security guard. It's believed that we are the purple guy and just living through, and 8-Bit Gaming had a great theory about how it's kind of like making us live through the terrors of the past and just kind of reliving everything and not being able to escape. And the repeated process of death, it's like if you guys have ever had a nightmare and you just kind of relive it every night and you can't quite get rid of it, that's kind of what he's dealing with, or our character is. But that's the thing, there's two different... There's two different main protagonists in the security guards, and that's... Jeremy and Mike Schmidt, and Jeremy, I want to say Fisher, but I don't think that's right. But that's what I'm just thinking. It's like, what do they have? In respect to everything else. Like, why are they in the game? What was kind of their purpose? Why are they in the game? You know, not saying that they're just blahs, but what's their real reason for being a part of the game? And I'm not saying that they aren't there for a good reason. But a lot of people are just wondering, like... You know, why are we there? Why are we a part of this?
Oh, that's sweet.
Why are they a part of this? Like, what do they have to do with all of it? So that's just kind of like my thing. It's just like, what do they specifically have in a role for all of this? And that's kind of a lot of the questions that people are having. And I can understand why. So it's just that thing. And then the Foxy, which has just been recently put up. The four main characters, Freddy, Bonnie, Chica, Foxy. And I haven't checked the website recently, so post down in the comments below. Because we know Golden Freddy is kind of a part of all this too. So is that another part of the whole story? Is he part of this as well? Hold on, guys. What movie is that?
Mom!
What movie is that?
I love you.
I gotta find the fizz gun.
Sorry, my family was playing a Saw movie,
and I was like, "What the heck? Like, what are you watching?" And then they told me, and I was like, "Oh, okay, well then, that's fine. I've already seen the Saw movies." I actually haven't seen all of them. I've seen most of them. But back to what I was talking about here. Why can't I get up? Alt to sprint. Alright, I gotta find out how I double jump. Yeah. crap. I gotta fix my moving. I gotta stop messing with that crap.
But I just think they'll go back to the original Fredbear's Family Diner.
Crap. But just based on the fact that we have no clue what happened in the original diner, and just some of the stuff that I've seen, it would just make a whole lot more sense for the franchise. If you guys remember, like I had said, there hasn't been much around. I don't know how to put it. We have not seen a whole lot. Around certain things, and I'll go to a multiplayer game. But certain things that we haven't had quite answered yet, specifically who the purple guy is, what Jeffrey and Mike and the phone guy all have in common. There's just so much that we don't know. And there's just so much. And I think the movie will clarify. My thought was that Scott wasn't gonna do the game because they were making the movie. When I heard that they were making the movie, I thought, well, it's probably a fake, you know, they're just... They're just trolling, just to get everyone happy, and then Scott's gonna say, oh no, we're not gonna come out and say, oh no, we're not, and that's just a huge lie, and it actually was never gonna happen. But when more people came out saying that it was gonna happen, and then reading on the website that Scott came out and said that the storyline of the game was already basically made for a movie storyline, like the five murders, the mysteries behind everything, a Chuck E. Cheese style place that's basically haunted. Oh god, I ain't playing on this map. It's just one that we knew from the beginning was gonna be really good. And I don't think a lot of us knew how good it was really gonna be. We thought, well, not many people really knew what the game was gonna be like. Scott made a few games here and there, I've heard, and I have not played any of them. I've heard a few of them were not great, and that he was thinking of giving up, and then the idea of Five Nights at Freddy's came to him, and that was a huge success. And I think you know after this he. You know, it's like a movie. When the first movie comes out, it's great. And then the second one, from the second one on, it just gets worse. Like I feel like that's how that, you know, if he makes another franchise after this, it's either not going to be as good or, you know, people are going to look at it and just be like, you know. That's just my idea. I really don't know. I mean, he can do whatever he wants. Yeah, I mean, that's fine with me. But I mean, who knows? Jeez, that took forever. But who knows? Who knows? I mean, that's just my thought. I mean, but whatever you guys is okay with me. It's just. That's up to him. I mean, it's really just down to what he wants to do, and I, you know, we're all gonna thank him at the end of the day for the Five Nights at Freddy's franchise and series. And when the game ends in the fourth one, which I mean, a lot of us thought it ended in the third, just by the end. But you know. I think this will definitely answer a lot of the questions that we have, and then it'll be that closing argument, I could say, to seal the franchise and just say this is the last hurrah. We're gonna answer all your questions in this final game, hopefully. Then you guys can speculate everything else if we haven't answered everything. And I think that's what it's going to do. It's going to give us, like I feel like what should be done. And this is just my thoughts. I mean, I can't have my opinion. But what he could do is have the intro of something like... You know, zooming in on the restaurant or whatever it is, and just kind of like a movie type feel intro to it, to just make it feel, you know, like. You know, like it's new, but it's not. And just have it in black and white if he does do the intro mini movie. To have it in black and white if it's about the original restaurant, have it in black and white just to make it feel like it has that flashback. You know? And do I think Springtrap will make an appearance? Yes, I do. I think Springtrap will be back. Because if you guys haven't seen the videos about him being with the little Freddy doll in the paper saying it burnt to the ground. And everyone's saying, well, if you enhance it, you brighten it, you can see Springtrap in the background. I think he'll make an appearance in the fourth game. Either by the flashback, or even if it's not a flashback. Whatever the case might be. It's just gonna be a huge change, and it's gonna be. Alright, I gotta leave that because there's not a whole lot. I don't want to go to ES Prop on 1 because I don't have that map and all thing. We'll just go back to the game. How much time is left? My dog's right behind me. But that's just my theories. I mean, you guys can post down in the comments below what you guys think the game will be, what your guys' thoughts are, where you think the game will take place, and what year, just based on the fact of was it me, just kind of raises that eyebrow of, you know, question like, what do they mean, was it me, like, you know, was it me as in, was I the one that did the bite, or, you know, just stuff like, alright, I need to get out of here, because, it's just not eventful. Savage Prevalence, it's actually kind of funny. But you know, remember, smash that like button, hit the subscribe if you're new here. Freddy Fraz beer. Actually, why not? I'll just stay here. But oh God. I don't know. It's a lot of questions. A lot of questions that not only I have, but a lot of other people have that I feel Scott will answer in the last game. And if he doesn't, and they do end up making the movie, which, just based on everything I've read and heard, they are, then will that come out in the movie? Get down. Get down!
Hold on, guys.
Sorry about that, my dog was trying to get food from our table. Thank you. I feel like my dog's just gonna get it somehow. Hey.
No.
But yeah, I mean, that's just...
Does anyone know, I mean,
hints, please?
Seriously. Jeez, but who knows?
Done. I eat everything.
I wish they'd fix the timer on this thing in the next update. I do. I like being able to tell when I can jump around when there's like 3 seconds left. I mean, otherwise you don't know. So you know. Who's dead?
That one no one else has mics.
Dinkelberg.
Timmy.
Oh my God.
Does he not see me?
No.
Go sandbox and we'll play a little bit, and that'll probably be the end of this video. But there's a bowling alley.
How are they getting it?
Basically, what's going to happen is I think you guys are going to drop it off the mall, and I'll meet up with them, we'll be able to walk over a bit, and then chase you over, and then chase them off the game, so I can see you.
So, no one's going to get it?
Why? I connect with them, I saw them, and they are going to go.
Where are you going? Airplane mode?
Is that really good? No, it's not working, so what's that doing? Pretty working.
I'll go bowling for a few, for a little bit, and why not? And I'll probably end the video once I get a strike. Probably I'll end it, which might take a while. But I'll be right back for a second. You'll see me get up.
Find out something.
Hey,
can I pull my money from my envelope?
Turn it back. So I'll end the video once I get a strike, which might take a little bit. But who knows? So. And then I'll probably do the video to. Going through what the steps to get the good ending. Or I'll put a link in the description for a different video that already has it done, because I mean it took me a while to finish all five nights again and get the good ending, because you know, I mean the one good thing is if you die and you've already done the mini games, you don't need to redo them. Because they're already done, so you can just keep going. Or you could do them again, I don't care. I mean, I did it once where every time I died, I'd redo the one or two for that night, depending on what night. And then at the end, I got the good ending, and then I did it where even if I died, I didn't redo that one for that night, and I still got the good ending, I think. But it was taking about 30 minutes to an hour, so I'm not. I mean, yeah, nah, it takes way too long. But, since this isn't quite loading, or not, alright, well, we'll go until I get a strike. And we'll use a crossbow just because, here, well, I'll use my tool gun to get some lights.
That moment when you realize you got the big power flag.
You're not going to win a tag, are you?
Yeah. Why not? Yeah. What's that?
Alright, I'm going to actually use the remover now. Because I think I added way too much. There we go.
What happened to him?
Why is that guy turned tail?
Now
I'll add a light again. They're already there, huh? Oh, alright. Well, what's up? James, help.
I'm literally going in my gun with my house.
Do you have all my money?
No.
Yep. All of it? Well, what's the bank?
No, sorry, I actually have $20-something. Make myself. Yeah, you should.
Yeah. You move on to the
end? Oh, darn it.
There it is. Is that what you mean?
No, it's a little on
20. What pool?
I cook.
It's not all gone? Yeah, I've got
all the
Come on, so.
No.
You aren't going to be here by yourself.
No, it's right here.
Where's my blue tank?
You're not going in, are you?
Darn it. I can't get a strike.
Yeah, I was trying to be with you. Oh, I have to get it then. 20
swag.
Come on, you're going to be late.
Bro.
Oh, my God, there's no Tupperware to put anything in because you took it all.
I'll bring a sweatshirt. It'll be fine.
You might get cold.
Clean
the
stuff that's dirty. No. Baggies in it.
Where's your black bag,
though? Where did
you do
that? Are you talking to me?
No.
Somebody talking to me?
Nope.
Not you. I'm talking to Ethan. Ethan,
are
you talking to me?
What
black bag? All his.
All right. Okay, let's grab a ball.
There we go. Done. Outfit complete.
That's weird. You don't even need sunglasses. It's raining out. No hat, because that was too much. Your outfit is perfect. Just the way it is. I would bring a sweatshirt.
You want to wear a hat for that?
I can't get a good ball strike. What the heck?
If I do say so myself, the shoes, yes, I understand. That's
like, it just looks like I'm wearing a dress.
But the chain, Dad. I mean, come on, Dad. That was sitting in your jewelry box.
So what?
I'm carrying on the legacy.
So what? If you like it so much, then you should just paint it for it.
That's ridiculous. He's your son.
Yeah?
He's your son. You say that's like part of the shit that bugged you as a kid.
What?
Father never
left. All right.
Father wasn't very good.
You know what?
With you.
What?
Yeah, I'm just gonna do this then.
Well, that they buy you something and you get it in a picture at Christmas and all that. Just give your son a freaking necklace.
Boom. Strike. All right. I'll see you guys next time.